Hello and welcome everyone to Mist of Ire? Ire? Ear? Wire? I'm assuming it's one of those. the pronunciation for the name I didn't see on their website, although it may be there. This is a place that I've had on my to-do list for a while, but I've been somewhat waiting for a time when I didn't have a number of videos in the month to do. As what we're about to see is that this place is fairly complex, as a lot of roleplay sims are. I'm going to go ahead and teleport. This actually wasn't where I was expecting to teleport. I'm just going to give this a moment to load. This actually wasn't where I was teleported last time when I used that, so... Okay. I'll go ahead and explain a couple things. This is a roleplay sim. You can come here and put on an Exerber tag and look around for yourself if you're interested in what you see here. It's essentially, from what I understand, a region that incorporates four factions. So there's four different types of people you can be. There's essentially a faction that... I'm assuming this is... The faction in the middle, which is essentially people that want to live in a city, and I'm trying to remember the name of it, but I can't remember for some reason. And I'm not sure if any of these buildings are actually privately owned, which is a little bit of a problem for me. But we'll just go ahead and take a look at the scenery for the moment, which it looks very nice. I originally came here a number of months ago and took a look at the place just a little bit and saw how complex this was, and decided to save it for a rainy day. But from what I've seen of it the last time I was here, this is probably one of the better... fantasy role-playing sims I've seen just from build alone. As what we're gonna see is that from here we're going to go across forest and find different faction areas, and essentially factions are the people here in this city, which I believe this is the middle of the region. There's a second faction that lives more in caves and like a volcano, and they're essentially more along the lines of... Ooh, that's not good already. Graphical corruption, let me take care of that. Okay. The second faction essentially is the supposed evil faction, essentially, where if you have people that perhaps don't have the best intentions, that would be the faction you would probably want to pick. The third faction are along the lines of nature lovers, the ones that aren't here in the city and they're actually living in a tree and really just want to have everything more natural, I assume. And the last ones are an aquatic faction, which I believe probably... have a large portion of the water under their control, from what I read. Like, essentially all the water in the sim belongs to them, so I'm not actually sure if they have a full-on area or not for them. I'm sure we'll figure it out. And this is actually a shop, which if I had looked around the corner, I would have seen... I would have seen that easier. So that's actually fairly neat for... Okay, there we go. Yeah, this is fairly neat, actually. The usually for shops and things, you would have to walk in to see exactly what they are, but these actually have windows to them, though maybe they're not actually used for shop. Oh, yeah, they are. There's a shelf there. Or a counter. And this place actually gets some fairly good... traffic. As you can see, there's a person off to my right a little bit, and there's a few other ones around. Obviously, with the observer tag on, I'm announcing that I'm not here for roleplay at the moment. Which I am always thankful when a roleplay sim gives me a server tab, so it doesn't seem as very awkward. And I have a avatar that I'm hoping is a little bit more in character for this area, which I do try to do. But in any case, I see that there's like fins and whatnot in the water. That's actually a nice little detail. One of the things I should point out is that I always run water with very basic water compared to the complexity of the other graphical stuff I use. Essentially because I don't like having stuff underwater necessarily spoiled for me. So probably if I had the water on like full blast, we'd probably be able to see the reflection of what's finning down there, which is probably sharks. But I'm sure we'll probably get a chance to take a look down there after a while, so no worries. I think this actually might have the name of the city on it. Let me see. Yep, here we go. Stormstead. That's what I was thinking of. That's essentially like the main city of the region, and essentially is its own faction. Now we have to choose where we want to go. I think I'll head this way, to be honest, because the other way seemed to kind of be a dead end towards those canoes. At least I'm assuming there's pathways around here. I guess we'll figure it out. But yeah, I actually when I teleported through the entrance area beforehand, I ended up on top of a rock that was just floating around, and I thought that was sort of like a initiation place or something along those lines. So I was kind of surprised when I actually got teleported down the sim this time around. I thought I was gonna have to use note cards to get around. Have a nice view of a waterfall here. Though my detailing just doesn't want to work with me right now, because I'm seeing a bit of texture blurring around, though it is starting to detail itself now. My computer just hates forests for some reason. It's like a mine. Okay. So I guess maybe there's some people that are miners, perhaps, or just essentially people that would come in here and take out material. Which to me has always been that one thing that's kind of like, I work a job that's essentially like being in customer service and things like that, and then sometimes I'll go home and play a role-playing game. Based on a space station, and essentially be a cargo technician there, and essentially be in customer service as well too. So it's like one of those things where it's like you want to do work and you role play, and it's always this weird like double thing. Now, I guess shopkeeping would be actually kind of fun, but I'm thinking like role-playing manual labor. This is a nice little spot here. They do make things distinct here, I have to say. It hasn't been like I haven't been able to go like 5 steps without seeing something that's interested me, so that's a really good sign. I don't know if this is a house or. Well, there's no door to it, and there's nothing out the front that would signify it is a house, so I'm assuming it's public. It's the only thing I like to watch out for is not necessarily barging into someone's, like, private house. Nice view of the trees over that way. And we have actually a faction sign right here, so this must be one of the faction areas right here. Let's see. Moa Ising. These are the ones that are more in tune to nature, I believe, if I remember correctly. So it makes sense that the area is caves and trees, essentially. Oh, we have a shop here as well. Sage Advice, Apothecary. Even though I was still able to read that, I still like to text refresh it. Now, this makes sense. It's selling plants and whatnot that you would know would work on certain things. I actually have really good views here, but that's probably because it's a gigantic forest, too. Because I actually, regularly, I have my distance set to 360, and I actually only have it set to about 200 here right now, and I still get really great view. Let's take a look beyond this real quick and see if there's anything else, but I think we might have to go back and get those vines and see what's up there first. Yeah, it looks like this might be just another path further across the region, so we're gonna go ahead and go back to these vines and see what's going on with this. There must be a clicky here somewhere that I'm not seeing. There we go. Sometimes my AO messes with the climbing animation, but this time it doesn't look like it did, so. I guess these would be beds, and here's a good view of a bit of the region off here. I'm really getting good distance, actually. And then here we see some of the village that we came from over that way. So we've actually made it kind of far already. Just trying to find the clicky for this. No? Ah, there we go. A nice view down below from there. Looks like a lounging area, actually. We're getting pretty high up. So I guess it's more like faction areas are more like lounging areas than actually having individual rooms, which actually is a fairly practical use of space compared to some other places that I've seen. I'm assuming this would be where the leader sits, actually. Or however it works. I don't think I'm actually going to climb down with these, so hopefully I don't just fall out of the tree completely. Okay, there we go. I guess like every faction area perhaps has an NPC around, because I saw one in Storm, in the city back there too. They might be for roleplay purposes though, I guess. Looks like there might be a house off this way. Is that another NPC right there? Oh, that's not an NPC. My bad. Yes, let's go ahead and continue on the path here and see where this takes us. Looks like we're heading more towards the ocean off that way, which is probably also the region end. Nice little stream here. There we go. Few little islands off that way, but doesn't look like there's anything on them, so. Looks like we're heading somewhere though. This I think is a path. I'm not quite sure. Actually, it looks like we might be back towards the village, like we've gone in a half circle. Perhaps the way I saw leading up out of the village was the way, off this way. It looks like there's another faction flag down here, too. Kavari's Deep. So these are the ones that I believe are more aquatic. So I'm gonna go ahead and just take a look at this beach for the moment. Oh, a cave. Hang on, let me go ahead and just take a look a little bit. Oh, the region barrier is like right here. That's a bit unfortunate. Perhaps this will lead to the faction area then. Since it's on the beach, let's see. I see a merset, and my avatar is kind of going crazy at the moment because it's trying to fall into the water, I think. Ah, there we go. Oh, this looks really nice. And I hear some bubbling noises too. There appears to be a stone on the ground here. A monolith. Looks like there is perhaps a couple of ways to go from here, and the only thing that's actually here that's above water is this little floaty, essentially. Okay, we'll go ahead and see what those underwater tunnels head to from here. These look nice. Though it appears to not actually head anywhere. Dead end from how it looks. Oh, it's nice that they actually detail even the dead ends, though. They actually detail quite a bit here. Oh, is that a way up? No, I'm actually poking through, I think, a rock here. So, no, that is not a good way up. Honestly kind of hope I don't run into, like a mermaid or something, because then it's gonna look weird having like a fairy or whatever just walking around underwater. This looks like it may have actually headed into back towards the middle, perhaps? We might actually be towards the town again. Let me see if I can. These are always a bit hard to text refresh because essentially you have to find the middle prim, but it's fine. Oh, another one of these monolith things. Quite a few of these around, apparently. Perhaps the aquatic faction doesn't particularly have their own area and just sort of have the entire waterways. That's essentially what I read on the website, I think. This area looks nice. Apparently, we just came out of a cave, though. Looks like there's a bridge off that way, but yeah, I guess we'll go this way for a moment. it's back the way we came from, so essentially we went around in a circle. So let's go ahead and take a look at that other tunnel then. This is fun. This is actually a really fun place to explore so far. Actually, it looks like I just ended up at a dead end. Okay, that's... I keep on getting kind of tricked by the areas above. So I guess a bit of the cave is... Oh, where am I? I was not expecting to come out on top of something like this. Huh. This is really nice. Apparently it looks like to be a shop, though. I have no idea what faction this would belong to. Perhaps in the nature one, since it has to do with mushrooms and stuff like that. I see a couple of ways out, so let's go ahead and take the door first. Well, this looks nice. Someone's a fan of Mad P, I see. I like had the auto just sidestep because of what I remember this door having to do with in that Mad P game, but wow, this actually, I am impressed. Like, whoever made this region really knows what they're doing. Just every place I go to is completely different from the last. Though, since we're by a volcano, I'm assuming this is the place for... essentially, that's... I forget the name of it. But essentially, that more evil faction? That's my initial assumption, anyways. And if that's the case, we've actually been to each of the four factions' areas, then. I see another shop thing over that way, it looks like. Let's go ahead and take a look at this ruin first, though. Oh, it actually opens. Hmm. Ebon Reach, that was the name of the fourth faction. The one that's more like... not as good intentioned as the others. Oh, I just doomed everything. That opened. Okay. Don't really want to hop into the volcano, so let's go back around. Actually, we can go underwater and take a look, because there's more underwater stuff. Okay, so maybe the mushroom store does belong to them, because I'm seeing more mushrooms around. Enter into the deeper reach. Huh, okay. There's a couple of tunnels along this way, too, and I think they perhaps take us back outside. Okay. I'm assuming that way went outside too. Just having bits of graphical corruption every once in a while. Oh, I can't walk into there. It's a teleport. Well, that's not good. Beyond this, it seems, oh, there's a door up this way, okay. So take a look what's behind this door. Oh, the door will not open, not to force, nor magic, nor cunning. Mysterious door will never open. I wonder what's behind that door, then. I forgot. Since I teleported elsewhere, this has to load up again. Okay. Let's head out, then. I'm not sure where exactly we ended up. So I'm just going to take a path and see where I head. From how that looks down there, I think that's where we came up from when we were doing the waterway, so we're not too far off from where we were before. Though I'm not seeing much more of a path this way, I don't think. Unless I wanted to retrace my steps back to where I was. So we're going to go ahead and... Is this a cave I've seen before? Let me see. This probably shouldn't look like this. Maybe this is something along on my end that's messing up. I'm not sure. Unless they just haven't built this area yet, I'm not sure. So I'm assuming it's either something on my end that's not loading up, or it's an area that they're currently building. Whoa, what the heck? Oh, that was intentional. Okay. I thought for a moment there I'd just like fallen through like some prim that wasn't set to physical. Oh, that's a trap. That's awesome. I legitimately did not even see that coming. I didn't even look at the ground. It looks like it's covered up fairly well, I think. Does the ladder actually work? Okay, there we go. Yeah, here it is. That's evil. That's the way I came from. Okay. Let's not fall down the hole this time and see what this looks like over here. Looks like a door. Oh, okay. The vines just moved. It's another mowing, izing spot. So the nature faction. Okay. Maybe this is where their leader's at? Kind of looks like a leader spot. Now, I believe we already saw a spot that kind of looked like a leader spot with them, so I'm not sure. Interesting. There we go. This, I believe, just takes us back that way. Actually, we're up towards the village again, or town. And. This is actually taking us back towards where we started when we left the town earlier. But I don't think we actually went all the way around to the right when we went this way, so we're gonna go ahead and do that now, I think. Just to try and cover everything. Yep, looks like there's more stuff here, so let's go ahead and take a look. Okay. This looks like perhaps a spot where somebody camped at one point. It looks like it. This is apparently the entrance to the nightcap. That was that mushroom store we went to before. Okay. And that's back towards where the region barrier is. We've made it back here, I think, like 3 times now. All right, so at this point, I think the only way we haven't gone is we haven't seen what's beyond the other way with the town, the way that had the canoes. It's the only direction I don't think I've gone yet. Though if I had to take a guess, it's probably gonna lead me back to the beach, so I guess we'll see. We'll definitely see. Though I have to say, I'm really impressed with this place. Like, if you enjoy fantasy role-playing, this is probably the region you want to head to. Or at least one definitely you would want to try. Because this sim is amazing. Okay, now I do think I may have to may have to restart my viewer here. Because that roof was missing. Yep, there is sharks down here. Yeah, it's this way we have to head off because I see something over this way. I know the town's not quite rising up properly, but since we've already explored it, I'm not too worried about it at the moment, so. This is an area I don't think we've been to over this way, or at least in this area. That's back towards Ebonheart, I think. Though I don't think we actually really found the entrances to it from outside so much. That's probably an entrance right there. Though they're monolith over there. Yeah, this looks familiar. Yeah, that's down to the Ebonheart faction area, so. I didn't realize this door was here, though. Oh, doesn't look like we can actually use it, though. This area looks nice over here with the waterfalls. I guess we'll continue off towards this way because I don't think we've been along the outer ring of the region this way, which I think this might be the only thing left. I think we've just about covered everything else. It looks like whether we have another, see, like a village or a campsite or oh, it's a neutral area. I didn't even think. Wow, they really covered everything. Nice. So you don't even have to necessarily pick a faction either. You could be neutral and have a spot here at this little camp. See a couple of little spots right here. Looks to be a small marketplace, perhaps. And there's another person right around as well. Handcrafted jobs and trades. Looks to be a blacksmith. Alright, we'll go ahead and take a look over at that area over there. I apparently did not see it at all earlier when I was looking at the canoes. I guess the wall was slightly higher than what I was looking at the time, which I think was towards the floor. Yeah, okay, these bamboo, I think, probably covered it up. Oh, it's a swamp area. I wonder if this is another... I wonder if this is faction-owned, or if this is... Well, we got somebody here. Looks like there's something over here from the spot. I'm walking up this wall, which... Okay. Apparently that's not a door, I guess. Definitely not a door. That's fine, though. Somebody's IMing me. Let me see how... Let me see what's going on here. Okay. That was just one of the admins for... The mist here, wanting to welcome me while it's exploring. Oh, the water makes, oh, it makes particle effects too, though it's not quite resting up for me at the moment. Nope, it's being difficult not wanting to res for me. Apparently this is the door. And it appears to be another shop. The Crone's Eye. So probably something along the lines of alchemy, just from looking at it. Swamps are neat, though. Looks like this area is actually closed off from what I'm seeing. It doesn't look like there's an actual way through here to anywhere. Besides back the way it came. At this point, I'm gonna go ahead and take a little bit more of a look around and see if I missed anything, because this place is rather excellent. So, I'm gonna do that, and gonna go ahead and camp up here, just to take a look at what's up here. Another nice waterfall display. I'm almost certain the beach is behind this mountain here. In any case, I will see you guys in a couple seconds, or otherwise, have a good day. Hello everyone, I managed to find another place that I apparently missed earlier. So we're going to go ahead and take a look at it. Apparently there's another building up here, part of the town, which is essentially a bathhouse, along with another waterfall area. Some fish down there too. Apparently I never saw this before, though it's kind of uphill and away from the town somewhat. And over here is, in fact, the beach, which, essentially, since this is right up against the swamp, I'm pretty much correct in what I was thinking before. And I found this cave, so we're going to go ahead and take a look at it. And inside is pretty nice looking, I have to say. Though I'm not sure of the purpose of what would be going on in here. It kind of looks like it kind of looks like a place that you would expect underwater, but it's not underwater, so I'm assuming it's not part of the deep faction. Maybe it is, I'm not sure, but I'm assuming not. Perhaps it's something just independent on its own. And here is another way up to it, apparently, as well. Though, since it's up here on top of this mountain area, I apparently never saw it. There's something off this way, too, so let's go ahead and take a look. Apparently this... oh, okay. This is definitely not an area that isn't rising up properly. I think it's just sort of... going through that wall is a bad idea, apparently. If I can... can I get back? There we go. In any case, I'm still sort of wondering... where the aquatic faction's place is, so I'm gonna go ahead and look around that. I'm assuming it's probably towards the beach. I probably missed it earlier. Or it might be in one of the water bodies, because here's the flag for it right here. And I don't think we actually went off this way. Let's see what's here. Ah, it seems to be a dead end. Okay. I'm going to continue looking around for the moment. So we'll see if I find anything else. So apparently my thinking earlier was wrong. When I hit up against the region barrier on the edge of the right of the beach, apparently that wasn't actually... I assumed it went across the beach and that this area wasn't actually had anything in it. But I am quite wrong on that. So apparently, obviously... the faction for the deep is right here under the water. And there's some people here, so I'm gonna just go ahead and cam down here instead of actually going down here, because as I said before, it looks kind of awkward if I'm just hanging around standing underwater. So here is the area for the mermaids and other aquatic creatures around, though I've only seen mermaids, so. But it looks really nice. But beyond this, I don't think there's anything else, as I've combed over pretty much everything at this point. There might be like something hidden around that I haven't seen yet, but I think I've done quite an extensive look around this region. And I would definitely recommend, if you're interested in roleplaying in Second Life and you enjoy fantasy settings, I would definitely give this place a try, because this is a really nice region from just looks alone, and I'm sure it's a really nice roleplay community as well. But in any case, I will see you guys in the next video, so see you then.